Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We made caramel popcorn the other day, and today we're making chocolate popcorn. So it's going to be made in the very same way, except I'm going to add some cocoa to it, and I want you to see it made. So we're starting out with some popcorn that Rick did down in the movie theater. Now you can use microwave popcorn, that'll be just fine. But what we're concentrating on is the topping. So we're going to make a chocolate topping. We'll start with 1/2 stick of butter. And I've already melted it. You can use it either melted or you can have it softened and ready to go. Then your milk. You need 2 tablespoons of milk. I'm using skim milk here. It doesn't really matter. And then you need some light brown sugar. I need 1 cup of firmly packed light brown sugar. And next will be our cocoa. To make these nice and chocolatey, I need 2 tablespoons of cocoa. And this is cooking chocolate or cooking cocoa. It is not cocoa mix for hot cocoa. It's not sugared down or with cream or anything like that in it. It's pure cocoa. And then I need 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. I don't know if you can tell that that's vanilla, but this is 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. And that's all of the ingredients that I have sitting out here that I'm going to need to cook right now. So I'm mixing these together, make a nice chocolatey mixture. You can go back and look at our previous video where we were down in the movie theater making the popcorn down there. We did it with an old-fashioned looking, but not really old-fashioned, popcorn popper. But as I said, you can definitely use microwave popcorn, or you can do it on top of the stove, however you normally make your popcorn. But you stir this around for the toppings, bring this over to the stove, turn on the stove, and you'll be bringing this up to a boil. You might want to watch while this comes up to a boil, because it was very solid, even though I had milk and melted butter in there. It just didn't seem like it was very liquid at all. But when you put heat to it, it's going to boil and bubble up. So let me turn this up just a little bit more. And once I first see it fully boiling, that's when I will start measuring the time. So I have a timer, or I can look at the second hand of my watch. And it just needs to cook for 1 minute, but it has to be at a full rolling boil. So I want to show you what that is. We're almost there. I see some little bubbles around the edges. Doesn't take long to hit the boil. Almost there. Okay, that's when I'm going to start the time, and I'm going to turn this down a little bit so it doesn't overboil, and I'll stir. So I'll be back after 1 minute. For exactly 1 minute, so I need to turn it off, get it off the stove, and bring it over here to a pad. And then immediately I need to add in 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. And you'll notice a dramatic change. See what it looks like now? It's very dark and bubbly. When I add this in and stir it, it's going to change its consistency quite a bit, and the color will change. It will lighten up and it will get all puffy. But that's what you expect, so don't get worried. It's doing just fine. What I need to do is to kind of keep an eye on this. I want to keep it moving because it can set up on you if you don't. But over here, I have buttered my large bowl and buttered spoon, actually used some spray cooking oil, and I'm going to put some of the popped corn in here. Actually, I can just pour that easier, I think, than trying to spoon it in. But I'll just start with that much of it. And by the way, you should remove your unpopped kernels. This is beginning to look like it wants to be used. So I'm going to just pour it down over the top. Just drizzle it along in there, and probably not put all of it in yet. Let's stir it around. So it should not stick to the spoon because of having oiled the spoon, but it should stick to the popcorn. So we're going to have a nice mixture of chocolate and popcorn. So just keep going with that And I think we'll use a little more popcorn. Not too much. And then pour the rest of that mixture in before it hardens up. It will harden quickly, so you need to be prepared to move very quickly as you are doing this. And there we go. There's a little bit left in there to lick, which we always take advantage of, so I'll set that aside and work on my chocolate popcorn. And some always ends in the floor, so don't think anything about that if it happens. What we're going to do at this point is try to get as much of this coated as possible. And if there are places that don't get coated that well, that's all right. But we'd like for it to hang together as much as possible. So the more stirring you can do, it's very hot, so you don't really want to touch it with your hands too much. That burns. But when you get it about like this, that's probably good enough. So you're going to take it from here and place it on wax paper. So just use a tray like this and have some wax paper on it. And if you have this bowl oiled, then this will slide out very easily. And you can just put it on your tray. Now we'll let it cool. And as it cools, you'll find that your popcorn will be sticking together. Excuse me, that went over the edge. Glued together by the chocolate. And then when it's completely cool, we'll break it apart and we will serve it in little bowls like this. I'm sorry about my hands. They look like they've been in mud. But we'll put them in little bowls like this. And to store it for a longer time, you can put it in an airtight container. So you can put it in some type of canister with a screw-on lid, or you can put it in a Ziploc bag and save it until you need it for a movie party or maybe a football game party, something like that. I think you'll really enjoy it.